Hey everybody, it's Kenny. Welcome back to another edition of the Yak with Mac. Riding solo today, I talk about the art of reinvention. Important stuff. Listen in. Hey there everybody, this is Kenny with another edition of the Yak with Mac, and I'm looking around, it's just me. It's just solo. It's just me. I haven't done this in a while. And you know, there's a lot going on in our organization with reorganization and stuff like that. So I had folks lined up, but a couple of folks were like, Kenny, could I just wait until we get through this whole reorganization thing? Of course, of course. And it gives me the opportunity to talk about a topic with you today. But first, folks, Leader Ready, we're way down the road. If you have not gone to Leader Ready yet, what are you waiting for? Make sure you've got that lined up. And we've got it for every channel, right? If you're in TPR, if you're in Metro, if you are in Core, Leader Ready is right out there for you. So many other leadership courses that you can absolutely take as well. I'm thinking sometime in July, I'll get somebody on to really talk a little bit more about leader paths and things like that. So stay tuned for that. Continued education is the thing. 15 minutes a day. Are you taking at least 15 minutes a day for your own self-development? And, you know, if you take a couple of days off from that, great. But if you do it for 5 days, that is fantastic. These days, though, the way the company moves, you should do a little something every day. So leaders, you got to take control of your own career and make sure that you're doing something for you every single day. Again, take 2 days off from it. That's fantastic. No worries there whatsoever. Okay. This is the place to come to, by the way. I've got some great guests that are going to continue to get lined up. This is where we want to encourage and inspire you to be influential leaders within your organization, no matter what organization you're in. Okay. So the org change thing got me to talk about this, got me thinking about talking about this. And I'm going to use a word that has, you know, been used before. I'm sure you've heard it, but we'll get a little bit more specific on what it should look, feel, and sound like for you. So I want you to personalize what we're going to talk about this morning, because I want to talk about the art of reinvention. Because while no one likes the thought of, oh my gosh, we've got a reorg coming, you know, everybody gets a little unsettled and a little nervous. I had to flip the script on that years ago, because I know, especially in my years as a DM, I would maybe have the same, I had the same core amount of stores for several years, but then I would get other stores added to my district, taken away after a year or two. So I sort of started to get in the habit of looking at any reorg in a positive way. And I started saying that was always a great way for me to reinvent myself. So I want to talk about the art of reinvention, because it's a good time, if you're going to a new team, to really take a look inward to see, are there some things about yourself that you need to change? And I can remember that I would have a group of stores, and then when I'd get another group of stores, I would say, you know, there were some things I did at the beginning that I should have did differently. And I'm going to do that differently as I introduce myself now to this new set of stores. And only you are going to know what that look and feels like. You can get, like, my boss could have told me some stuff. Hey, Kenny, do this a little differently. And I certainly listened to that. But all inwardly, I was the only one that really knew what those things were that I needed to do differently. So leaders, I'm looking at you and I'm talking to you. You know what you would, if you had a do-over with your current group, what you would have done differently at the beginning. And so now you've got an opportunity to go to a new group. Take those same things and now put them into place. This is your chance for reinvention. So I want to be real clear on what I'm talking about here when I talk about reinvention. The core of you shouldn't change. You're successful for a reason. You've got some great qualities. You've got some great characteristics. You're in the position of leadership that you are for a reason, right? For probably a lot of reasons. So the core of you probably should not change. However, Maybe you can change the peripheral of you. Maybe you can change the outskirts of you. And I want to tell you, think about some companies over the years, and I'm going to name some companies that we're all young and old enough to remember, right, when they were prominent and they didn't perfect the art of reinvention, so the business passed them by. So leaders, that's my reason for talking this morning. The last thing I want is for the business to pass you by if you are slow in reinventing yourself. This is a perfect opportunity with folks who don't know you to reinvent yourself. So think about Blockbuster, right? We all remember Blockbuster Video. Netflix passed them. Blockbuster never caught up. They didn't know how to reinvent themselves. They didn't know how. There's a lot of technical reasons why they, you know, went south the way they did, but the core of it is that they didn't know how to reinvent themselves. Sears. Sears was a company that was a top retailer when I was young. Yeah, they were a top retailer and not Walmart, right? They certainly never was able to catch up or reinvent themselves. Sometimes it's stubbornness. And I have read a lot of articles that with Sears, it was a stubbornness that if we just stuck with our model that it was going to come back, everything was going to be good. They were wrong. I hate to say that. They were wrong. Toys R Us, another one that we're all young. It's only been a couple of years that Toys R Us has been going. We're all old or young enough to remember Toys R Us very well. And they also had a tough time catching up with the times. Also, I've read very stubborn in terms of looking to change and change their business model, reinvent themselves. Here's one that hurt because a lot of us loved our BlackBerry back in the day. And that's not that long ago. I still thought BlackBerry had the best email platform. And BlackBerry just didn't listen, right? When we said, hey, you know, the phone takes too long to reboot, to restart, if it gets stuck in a loop. And, you know, the browsing experience is not that great. And along came the iPhone. And once the iPhone really perfected their, you know, iOS model, and, you know, you could go and get email the same way, BlackBerry was done. And they've tried to come back a couple of times. They've tried to reinvent themselves a couple of times. But sometimes that reinvention can be too late. So there's a key point that I wanted to make as I said that with BlackBerry, right? Sometimes that reinvention is a little bit too late. So that's why take advantage of this reorg that we're all probably being impacted in right now to go ahead and do that reinvention. Let me give a couple of other examples of some two very, very famous people that reinvented themselves. And some of us may not even have realized it. I remember I realized it at the time. Michael Jordan, right? Listen, arguably the greatest player of all time. So you guys know I'm not a big Jordan guy because he broke my heart every year by beating my Knicks. But anyway, he certainly was a phenomenal, phenomenal player. But when you think about when he got into his 30s, when he got those last three championships, if you look back on his games in the 80s and even in the early 90s, he was a high flyer. He used to jump over people. He used to take off from the foul line and do these spectacular dunks. If you look at his last couple of years, it was rare that you saw him do that. What you did see him do a lot was he would drive to the basket a lot, which was great, but he perfected his jump shot. Remember, his last shot as an NBA player that won a championship was about a 20, 25-foot jump shot against Utah, if everybody remembers that famous video, right? So Jordan reinvented himself by getting better at some other things because he knew that physically he couldn't do some things anymore. So whatever the motive is, there was reinvention there. I'll talk about another very, very famous people that a lot of folks don't remember, I barely remember as well, is Elvis Presley. He was famous really from 1954 was when he had his first hit song. And then he was still famous. He had a number one song in 1972. That's a long time later. But his music in between evolved. He started making a little bit more serious messages like In the Ghetto and Kentucky Rain, more ballads, using his voice more, got a little bit more of an R&B type feel. He evolved over the years because he knew that by the mid 60s, there were a lot of people singing the rock and roll that he was singing back in the 50s. So he felt like he had to reinvent himself. And plus, he was getting a little older, right? When I say older, he was in his 30s. But he felt like he shouldn't, you know, gyrate the way he did back when he was in his 20s. And he was very famous in the 50s. So he evolved and still stayed really famous, really popular through the years. So again, no matter what the motive is, it's a good time to reinvent. Let me give you three specific ways that you can sit down and really think this through and reinvent yourself Just a little bit. Again, on the periphery, right? On the periphery. Don't do a full makeover. You are who you are, and you are successful because of who you are. So just some tweaks here and there. So three things. The first thing is, let's go back to emotional intelligence. You've got to see yourself outside of yourself. Remember we talked about that during emotional intelligence. You've got to have a great self-awareness of who you really are, the leader that you are at your core. Okay, so you've got to see yourself outside yourself. And when you do that, you're going to look at yourself with a critical eye and say, you know what, that part of me, I don't really like. I need to change that. I need to change that. I don't do that well. I need to get better at it, whatever that might be. So see yourself outside yourself. I've talked about this before. This is the time to really call on those alert circles. If you have not gotten an alert circle yet, 4, 5, 6 trusted peers that tell you the real deal, that tell you what's coming next. If you've not formed that yet, please do that. And if you have, now's a good time to call on them and say, hey, what would a reinvention of Kenny really, really look like? And get some trusted people to tell you that. If you've got the right people in your alert circle, they will absolutely give you the best possible advice. Okay, third thing, and it's a two-part question. It's two questions in this third one. What are some new habits that you want to form? What are some skills and that you've thought about over the last couple of years that, man, I'd like to get better at that. Now's a good time to do that. So what are some good habits that you'd like to form? Maybe it's that 15 minutes a day that you haven't been doing, but you've wanted to do. Now might be the opportunity to do it. And then the second part of that is, what are some old habits that you want to drop? What are some things about you that you're not crazy about? Some habits, you know, maybe that's you wake up a little bit later and you always wanted to wake up a little earlier. You know, maybe that's one. Make that personal for you. So think about some new habits that you want to form and some old habits that you might want to break. Okay, the art of reinvention. Three things that I'm going to advise you as we recap and we end here. See yourself outside yourself, right? Really be critical of you and how other people perceive you. If you haven't already gotten that alert circle, form that. If you have it already, make sure it's a good time to call them. Make sure you get some feedback on how you can reinvent yourself. Maybe it's just one little thing that you want to do. That's fantastic. And then what new habits would you like to form and what old habits do you want to leave behind? All right, leaders. I am going to have some great guests lined up. I already have them lined up. Can't wait to share that with you. But for now, this is Kenny with another edition of the Yak with Mac. We will talk to you next week.